In this video, we are going to see the creation of sales set. So the transaction code is pretty much the same. Instead of article category prepack, I'm going to create it as a sales set. The difference between the sales set and the prepack is that the prepack should have the articles of same merchandise category, and it should have the variants of a generic article that belongs to the same merchandise category. In other words, you will not be able to add the single material into a prepack component. Whereas in sales set, you don't have such restrictions. You can add the single material or a variant of a generic material that can belong to different merchandise categories. So let us compose it as I don't want to give any article master. 57 is what we created, right? So okay, so instead of that, let us say like beach pack is already, so we will create a similar version of okay summer beach pack. So in this beach pack, I am going to add one speedo, one towel, one beach shorts, and a swimming goggles. Okay, so these are all the articles I have created already, and I am going to use these things in our beach towels, excuse me, surfing shorts, after surfing, like when you want to get wet in water, you might want to wear a speedo or a swimming trunk. Once you are done with, you might want to wear a tank top and a surfing short. Okay, you might need a towel. So I'm going to pack all these things in a single sales set. So let me go to make my components. My component, first I am picking up the goggles, 100038, one piece, a towel. I want to add one speedo, 10045. This is a variant article, so I should add a variant of this article. What happens if I add it directly? It will give an error like article category 01 of is not allowed. So I have to add its variant. I think it's 3. Okay. And I want to add one tank tops. So it is 10043. 100043001. Okay, let me look for something that belongs to a different merchandise category. So all of these things belong to the same merchandise category, 001. I might want to add, let me say that I want to add one music audio CD. My favorite is the retro 10271 Dil to Pagal Hai audio CD. So this is audio CD, and all this rest belongs to this merchandise category called WW Men. And if there is anything, okay, fine. So this is what I want to carry when I go to beach. I want to listen to good music, and I want to have all these swimming accessories. And I have created these stuffs. So I am setting up the price. So let me put it as 20. No, I should have selected all the tabs. Okay. So now the sales price has changed. Logistics DC. It's pretty much the same everything. If I had chosen all the tabs at the time of creation, the selection itself, we will not face this. What happened is I had selected only the basic data and entered into the article master. After that I am clicking each tab, so that is why it is picking those the internal vendor and this distribution chain. Okay, so it's anyway, it's of no problem. So let me save it. So now let us create a purchase order for this. So before that, let me do the listing activities / WSP4. So this is the first time I'm showing you the listing. So this is for the group of stores. Group of DCs. I think we had seen this classification, this grouping of sites in the classification video. So what happens, like I had grouped all my DCs together, all my stores together, so that when I'm creating the listing, I'm doing it for the group instead of doing it for individual sites. Okay, now let me create a material master, sorry, purchase order. For articles is 100000 58 100 pieces. I am ordering at DC. See, it explodes at the component level, to the component level. Okay, so you could see the pricing is done at the header level, not at the components level. Okay, let me save it. / mm, sorry, PL31N. I have to create an inbound delivery for this because my confirmation says it should be an inbound delivery. So when you are creating the inbound delivery, the delivery is created for the header alone. So what is there in the log? No goods accepted, it's not an issue. Let me do the goods receipt for this. Okay, we have created, we have done the goods receipt. Let me go and check these stocks. MMBE 10058 in W001. Yes, I am able to receive the material as a pack in this DC. Okay. So this is how you create and manage a sales set. The primary difference between the prepack and a sales set is the prepack should contain materials from the same merchandise category and it should contain the variants of a generic article. No single article allowed there. In case of sales set, you can have materials from different merchandise categories and you can have a single article or variant of a generic article all put together to form a sales set. That's all for now. In the next videos, we will see the display and structured articles. Have a good day.